Hi, you're watching the news with me, I'm Dipavli Hazra. These are the headlines at the top of 9. Senior BJP leader and former External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj was cremated with full state honours at the Lodi Crematorium today. Sushma Swaraj died aged 67 of a cardiac arrest. Political leaders cutting across parties paid their respects to her, remembering her as a warm personality and an exceptional minister. Meanwhile, Delhi and Haryana have declared a two-day state mourning for Sushma Swaraj. President Ramnath Kovind and Prime Minister Modi paid their last respects to Sushma Swaraj at her residence. A visibly emotional Prime Minister greeted the late leader's family. Vice President Venkaiya Naidu too stood by the mortal remains of his Rakhi sister. L.K. Advani penned an emotional tribute, and many of her party colleagues say that her passing away is a personal loss to them. National Security Advisor Ajit Doval was in the valley today to review the ground situation after the state of Jammu and Kashmir was bifurcated. Doval shared a meal with locals in the Shopian district at a closed market as he chatted with them about their well-being. Doval was also heard explaining to them the centre's move. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan chaired the National Security Committee meeting today, where decisions were taken that weaken ties with India further. Pakistan has downgraded diplomatic relations with India and suspended bilateral trade. The decisions were spurred by India's move to revoke Article 370. Day two of hearings ended in the Ayodhya title suit case. Supreme Court asked the Nirmohi Akhara for documentary evidence to prove its possession of the disputed land. The Akhara said that the records were lost in a dacoity that happened in 1982. The Akhara had yesterday argued that prayers in the mosque had ceased since decades. The Reserve Bank of India cut the repo rate by 35 basis points to 5.4%, which is the lowest in the last 9 years. This is the fourth cut in a row since Shaktikanta Das took over as the governor in December 2018. The move by the Monetary Policy Committee comes in the backdrop of an economic slowdown, low inflation, trade wars and geopolitical tensions. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.